We have an application where all tests are passing, actually only one. But if we try to test the coverage, we see that the coverage is 100%. Does this mean that the application is absolutely free of bugs? Well, obviously not. Let's give it a try. For example, this simple function calculates the sum of an array of numbers. So if we just run with the input here, 10, 30, 30, we get 70. Pretty easy, right? But what happens if the input is null? Well, as you might guess, we get an error. But why did we get an error? We see that the coverage was 100%. Well, focusing on code coverage alone is actually a waste of time. You will find yourself working hard to get that number higher and higher so that the threshold meets the expectations, so that your CI builds passes, and you have that wrong feeling of having a code base really solid just because code coverage is a high number. But then you get an unexpected input and everything falls apart. Why does this happen? Well, that's because the goal should not be focusing of having 100% code coverage or high code coverage in general. The focus of writing tests should be making sure that your business logic, where the customer gets their value, is actually tested against all possible inputs, or at least the most common inputs and the edge cases. For example, if a function gets a null. There's a famous tweet floating around from years, which I can find is from Brennan Keller, but I'm actually not sure if he's the original author, but that's where most pictures come from. And the tweet says, a QA engineer walks into a bar, orders a beer, and actually you already have probably 100% code coverage, but also orders 0 beers, orders 9999 beers, orders a lizard, minus 1 beers, and orders a random string of beers. And then it continues, because the first real customer walks in and asks where the bathroom is. And then the bar bursts into flames, killing everyone, because we only focus our tests, really strong tests, resilient against all inputs, on the amount of beers. We didn't even consider that customers might even just ask where the bathroom is. And it's just a funny joke, right? But if you think deeper, that's exactly the focus. You want to write your test on the behavior the real customer is gonna have, rather than on the amount of lines covered in the coverage report. This is kind of a common misconception, because seeing a high number of code coverage gives you a really solid feeling of being a robust and strong technical code base. But then, as you can see, as soon as you get a null, everything falls apart. And that's quite expectable. The thing is, if you only focus on the threshold, you will find yourself writing a ton of useless tests and you will be overlooking to the actual important tests you have to write. You should put most of your effort on focusing on the business logic, what gives value to the client and what the customer is gonna do when using your application. That's why code coverage alone is not the only indicator of a robust code base or well-written tests. Obviously, code coverage is not inherently bad. Try to look at code coverage as mostly an indicator of what parts of your application are not tested well enough. And for example, if the low code coverage highlighted that a module is not tested enough, and you find that it's not tested because the code is actually hard to test, well, that's another red flag. Was it hard to test because of its structure? Does it have too many dependencies? You might want to refactor your code so that you can finally test the functions that really matter to the business logic. See, you just use code coverage as a tool and not as a goal. You didn't just try to make the code coverage higher, but you used the low code coverage to find where the code needs to be tested more. And then you refactor your code, and only then you have a more solid and robust code base, and you also have more tests. Actually, if you focus on the business logic, on the most important parts of your code, you will find that code coverage will be higher by itself, because as long as you focus on the important function, you will likely cover the vast majority of the code in the tests. And then with the coverage, with the line-by-line coverage, you can notice that maybe some functions were left and you can add the additional tests for those specific functions. So as you can see, the reasoning is upside down. You're not focusing on code coverage, But code coverage is helping you focusing on the right tests. And then you go back raising that code coverage number to make sure the application is even more tested. So what do you think? How do you decide which lines to test first in your code base? Or for example, does your company have a threshold, or do you use a threshold in your project? Meaning that if you're below a certain threshold of code coverage, the CI is gonna fail. What do you think? Let me know in the comments, because I'm really curious about hearing from you and your personal or your company approach. With that said, feel free to subscribe to my channel here or continue watching here. This video is actually selected by YouTube specifically for you, so you might be find it interesting because YouTube thinks so. So, click here, subscribe, thanks for watching, and see you soon!